Welcome to Savvy IT Solutions. In this video, we learn about else if part 2. Already in the part 1, we discussed about what is else if, the syntax of else if, and we are taking where exactly the else if is used and syntax of the else if, and two examples are discussed. In this video, we need to take two more examples for better understanding of else if ladder. Okay, so here we are discussing about else if. So in the last class also we discussed the syntax. Apart from this, here we also learn about flowchart for this else if. Okay, else if ladder. If the condition is true, then statements one is executed. If the condition one is false, then again we need to check the second condition two. If this is true, then statement 2 will be executed. If this condition is false, then condition 3 will be checked. If this is true, then statement 3 will be executed. So on it moves. Okay. At the end, we are using else to come out from the loop. Come out from the condition. Okay. This is what exactly the if else statement. Now, I will draw a flow chart related to the else if statement. So here, I will erase it and okay. So now condition 1, yes, statement 1, no. Again we need to check one more condition. That is condition 2, statements 2, no. Again condition 3, statements 3, at the no. So somewhere we closed it. So here I am stopping the condition. So we need to link all the conditions and finally we connect it. This is the flow representation of else if ladder. Okay, now we are moving to discuss about write a Java program to print grade of a student. Before discussing about the grade, already in the last video we discussed how we are calculating the grades. So here marks and grade, we will take only these two. One more thing is there, that is points. When we are discussing about SGVA program, then we are discussing about that. We will discuss that part. Okay, so initially it is greater than equal to 85 O grade, in between 75 to 84 A, 65 to 74 B, and 55 to 64 C, and 45 to 54 D, and 40 to 44 E, less than 40 fail. Okay, according to this we will write the syntax. Okay, now I am checking if em greater than equal to 85, system dot out dot println o, else if m greater than equal to 75, system dot out dot println a, else if m greater than equal to 65, system dot out dot println b. Similarly, else if m greater than equal to 55, system dot out dot println c. Else if m greater than equal to 45, system dot out dot println d. Else if m greater than equal to 40, system dot out dot println e. Else system dot out dot println f. So this is the way we are finding grade obtained to a particular subject in for a student. Okay, so the next program is write a Java program to print the roots of the quadratic equation. So before discussing about roots of the quadratic equation, we need to know what is the quadratic equation. Ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0, where a not equal to 0 is called a quadratic equation. When this expression is came, so a not equal to 0, then it is a quadratic equation. If a is equal to 0, then it is called a linear equation, bx plus c is equal to 0. Okay, that is what exactly. So this is not exactly a not equal to 0, means it is a quadratic equation. Then we need to find the roots. The roots are minus b plus or minus root over b square minus 4ac by 2a. Okay, then before going to this, we find discriminant or delta is equal to b square minus 4ac. Now this d is equal to 0, roots are real and equal, okay. If d greater than 0, real and unequal, so d less than 0 imaginary roots. So according to this, we will make the program. So if the input is read a b c, means the coefficient of x square, coefficient of x, and the constant. We need to read the values of these three. So after that, we need to find the b square minus 4ac. Based, if we need to check a not equal to 0, then we check this is true. Then based on this, we need to check these three conditions for making it. Okay, so initially, if a not equal to 0, then only this is possible. Otherwise we go for else part and we cannot find the roots of the quadratic equation. So the first part is, this is true. Once, okay, that is not possible. So then what I need to do, I need to cut a not equal to 0. Very clearly I need to write. Okay, now if this is true, then d is equal to b into b minus 4 into a into c. Okay, after that we need to check one more condition. If d is equal to 0, if this is true, then we need to print system dot out dot println roots are real and equal. So if this part is 0, means this part is 0, then the roots are minus b by 2a. So r1 is equal to minus b by 2 into a, and r2 is equal to r1, and we need to print the roots of r1 and r2. So just I am writing r1, r2. Okay, when I am doing it practically, I will explain in detail very clearly. So here, else if d greater than 0, it means that this is greater than 0, definitely the roots are real and unequal. System dot out dot println roots are real and unequal. Now the r1 is equal to minus b plus math dot sqrt of d whole by 2 into a. Similarly, r2 is equal to minus b minus math dot sqrt of d whole by 2 into a. So we need to print these two roots r1, r2. So here it closes. So we need to write else part. Okay, so now I am clearing it. Final else part means it is less than 0, we need to print system dot out dot println roots are imaginary. Okay, now r1 is equal to minus b by 2 into a, and r2 is equal to math dot sqrt of d by 2 into a. So after that, I will write else system dot out dot println roots are imaginary. R1 is equal to minus b by 2 into a, and R2 is equal to math dot sqrt of d by 2 into a. So the roots are system dot out dot println, okay, R1 plus I R2 plus some space R1 plus minus I R2. So the reason behind this is printing one root and this is printing another root. So the imaginary roots are a plus r minus ib. So always they are also conjugate. So a plus ib and a minus ib are the roots of the quadratic equation. So this is first part and this is second part in between plus I. This is first part and this is second part in between minus I we put it. Okay, this is closing if this part and finally we need to close. So that if and else is closed, we need to print system dot out dot println the equation is linear, not quadratic. Okay, so that is what exactly we are making in detail. In the next video, we will make these four programs in practically. Okay, so that is what exactly we are. Thank you.